Hello, I'm Christina Yanoula, and in this talk I will introduce ParsePI, the first sparse matrix vector multiplication library for real processing memory architectures. In this work we designed 25 efficient sparse matrix vector multiplication kernels for real processing memory systems, and we provide the first extensive study of the sparse matrix vector multiplication kernel on the first real-world processing memory system. Our study leads to recommendations for architects and software designers of PIM systems. Let's start with the motivation of this work. Sparse matrix vector multiplication is a fundamental linear algebra kernel and lies at the heart of many important applications from the scientific computing, machine learning and graph analytics domains. In commodity systems like CPUs and GPUs, it has been repeatedly reported to achieve only a small fraction of the peak performance, and it is primarily bottlenecked by the memory bandwidth of the system. At the same time, several manufacturers have already started to commercialize near-bank processing memory or PIM architectures. A PIM system consists of multiple PIM-enabled memory modules connected to a host CPU via common channel-based connections. Each PIM-enabled memory module supports several PIM cores, each PIM core is located close to a DRAM bank. As a result, real PIM systems can provide high levels of parallelism, low memory access latency and large aggregate memory bandwidth, thereby being a very good fit to accelerate the SPMV kernel. A few real near-bank PIM architectures are Samsung's VMDRAM, SK Hynix AM and the UpMem PIM system. To this end, we make two key contributions. First, we designed SparsePI, the first SPMV library for real PIM architectures. We proposed 25 efficient SPMV kernels supporting several compressed matrix formats, data types, data partitioning techniques, load balancing schemes, and synchronization approaches in order to cover a wide variety of matrices and applications. And second, we conduct a comprehensive study of the popular SPMV kernel on the first commercially available PIM system. Our characterization study includes a wide range of sparse matrices with diverse characteristics and comparisons to state-of-the-art CPU and GPU systems. Our analysis provides recommendations for software system and hardware designers. Let's take a look on our proposed SPMV kernels. The end-to-end SPMV execution on a real PIM system can be broken down in four steps. First, the time to load the input vector into DRAM banks of PIM-enabled memory. Second, the time to execute the SPMV kernel on PIM cores. Third, the time to retrieve from DRAM banks to the host CPU results for the output vector. And finally, the time to merge partial results and assemble the final output vector on the host CPU. Our evaluated system does not have PIM-enabled memory as the main memory of the system, and thus we need to load the input vector to PIM-enabled memory modules. However, our kernel implementations would be the same and can be applied to an architecture where the PIM-enabled memory constitutes the main memory of the system. SparsePI supports two types of data partitioning techniques. First, we design a 1D partitioning technique where the matrix is horizontally partitioned across PIM cores. And second, we design a 2D partitioning technique where the matrix is partitioned in 2D tiles, the number of tiles is equal to the number of PIM cores. With the 1D partitioning, almost the entire SPMV computation is performed using only PIM cores, since PIM cores directly compute the final elements for the output vector. However, the input vector needs to be replicated at each DRAM bank of PIM-enabled memory, and thus the number of copies of the input vector that is transferred to PIM-enabled memory through the narrow memory bus is equal to the number of PIM cores used. With the 2D partitioning technique, we aim to strive a balance between computation and data transfer costs, since only a subset of the elements of the input vector is copied into the DRAM bank of each PIM core. Therefore, the number of copies of the input and output vector that are transferred to PIM-enabled memory depends on the number of vertical partitions used. In the 1D partitioning technique, we provide various load balancing schemes across multiple PIM cores for the four most widely used compressed matrix storage formats. For CSR and CU formats, we load balance either the number of rows or the number of non-zero elements across PIM cores. For BCSR and BQ formats, we load balance either the number of blocks or the number of non-zero elements across PIM cores. However, load balancing depends on the characteristics of each compressed format. Specifically, in CSR format, since the matrix is stored in row order, load balancing of the non-zero elements across PIM cores is performed at a row granularity. Instead, in Q format, the matrix is stored in non-zero element order, and load balancing of non-zero elements can be performed by splitting a row across two neighboring PIM cores, thus providing a near-perfect non-zero element balance across PIM cores. Similarly, in BCSR, load balancing is performed at a block row granularity. In the 2D partitioning technique, SparseP supports three schemes for all the four compressed matrix formats. In the equally sized scheme, the 2D tiles are statically created to have the same height and width. This way, the subset of the elements for the input and output vectors have the same sizes across all PIM cores. However, this scheme has high non-zero element imbalance across PIM cores due to creating static partitions on a sparse matrix. Second, in the equally wide scheme, the 2D tiles have the same width and variable height. We load balance the number of non-zero elements across the tiles of the same vertical partition. In this scheme, the subset of the elements for the input vector has the same size across PIM cores, while the subset of the elements for the output vector varies across PIM cores. This way, we provide high non-zero element balance across PIM cores of the same vertical partition. And finally, in the variable size scheme, the 2D tiles have both variable width and height. We load balance the number of non-zero elements both across the vertical partitions and across the tiles of the same vertical partition. This way, we provide high non-zero element balance across all PIM cores used. Finally, since real PIM architectures can support multi-threaded PIM cores, in both the 1D and the 2D partitioning techniques, we support various load balancing schemes and synchronization approaches among threads of a single multi-threaded PIM core. Overall, SparseP supports 9 1D partition kernels and 16 2D partition kernels, and a wide range of data types, including both low-precision integer and high-precision float data types. Let's now take a look on the most important key takeaways from our analysis. This is the real UpMemPIM system that we use in our evaluation. It includes 20 UpMemPIM DIMMs connected to a host CPU, having a total of 2560 PIM cores. Each PIM core can support up to 24 threads, which can access data from a local 64 MB DRAM bank. We evaluate a wide variety of sparse matrices. When the standard deviation of the non-zero elements across rows and columns of the matrix is low, the matrix is referred to as regular. However, when the standard deviation of the non-zero elements across rows and columns of the matrix is high, the matrix becomes very irregular and it is referred to as scale-free matrix. We first examine only the kernel time of the SPMV execution. We compare the four compressed matrix storage formats by normalizing their performance to that of the CSR format. In the 1D partition kernels, we find that in scale-free matrices, Q and BQ formats significantly outperform CSR and BCSR formats. This is because they provide higher non-zero element balance across PIM cores because CSR and BCSR formats are limited to perform load balancing at row and block row granularity, respectively. Similarly, in the 2D equally sized kernels, even though all compressed formats have the same load balancing across PIM cores because of the static partitioning, the non-zero element balance across multiple threads of each PIM core is affected by the compressed matrix format used. Therefore, Q and BQ formats outperform CSR and BCSR formats, especially in scale-free matrices, because they provide higher non-zero element balance across threads within a multi-threaded PIM core. And finally, in the 2D equally wide and variable size partitioning schemes, we find that Q and BQ formats significantly outperform CSR and BCSRs, both in regular and scale-free matrices. This is because Q and BQ provide high non-zero element balance across PIM cores and across threads within a PIM core. Our main key takeaway is that the compressed matrix format used to store the input matrix determines the data partitioning across DRAM banks of PIM-enabled memory, thereby affecting the load balance across PIM cores with the corresponding performance implications. Therefore, we recommend software designers to propose compressed data structures for sparse kernels that can be effectively partitioned across DRAM banks with the goal of providing high computation balance across PIM cores and across threads within a PIM core. Next, we characterize the end-to-end SPMV execution, including the data transfer cost for the input and output vectors. We evaluate the scalability of all data partitioning techniques as the number of PIM cores increases. Performance is normalized to that with 256 PIM cores. We find that the scalability of the 1D partitioning technique is limited by the low data transfers because the amount of bytes that is transferred to PIM-enabled memory through the narrow memory bus for the input vector grows linearly with the number of PIM cores. We conclude that the 1D partition kernels are bottlenecked by the high data transfers to broadcast the whole input vector into each DRAM bank of all PIM cores, and to this end, we suggest hardware and system designers to optimize the broadcast collective in data transfers to PIM-enabled memory in order to minimize the overhead of copying the input data into all DRAM banks of the PIM system. Second, we find that the 2D equal size kernel is bottlenecked by the kernel time. Specifically, the kernel time is limited by only one PIM core or a few PIM cores assigned to the 2D tile with the largest number of non-zero elements. And finally, we find that the scalability of the 2D equally wide and 2D variable size kernels is limited by the retrieve time to transfer the results for the output vector to the host CPU. These schemes are severely bottlenecked by the high amount of padding with empty bytes performed in the parallel transfers to retrieve results for the output vector. Our evaluated system supports parallel transfers at rank granularity, meaning among 64 PIM cores, and therefore a high amount of zero padding is performed in retrieved data transfers, accounting approximately the 80% of the data transfer from PIM-enabled memory to the host CPU. We conclude that the 2D equally wide and variable size partitioning schemes require fine-grained data transfers at DRAM bank granularity to be supported by the PIM system to achieve high performance. To this end, we suggest hardware system designers to optimize the gather collective operation and provide parallel data transfers at DRAM bank granularity having zero padding in order to significantly minimize the overheads of retrieving the final output results on the host CPU. And finally, when we compare the end-to-end performance of all data partitioning techniques, we find that the equally sized 2D partitioning technique performs best in regular matrices, and the 1D partitioning technique performs best in scale-free matrices. However, in all sparse matrices, best performance is achieved using a much smaller number of PIM cores than the available PIM cores of the system. There are many idle cores in the system because the best performing SPMV execution is a trade-off between computation and data transfer costs. We conclude that expensive data transfers to and from PIM-enabled memory module performed via the narrow memory bus impose significant performance overhead to the end-to-end SPMV execution, and therefore it is hard to fully exploit all the available PIM cores of the system. To this end, we recommend software, hardware, and system designers to provide high-speed communication channels and optimized libraries in data transfers to and from PIM-enabled memory modules to provide hardware support to effectively overlap computation with data transfers in the PIM system and also to integrate the PIM-enabled memory modules to be the main memory of the system. And finally, we compare the SPMV execution on the UPMEM PIM system with that of a common CPU system and a GPU system. In the GPU system, we also account for the time to transfer one instance of the input vector from main memory to the GPU global memory and also the time to retrieve the final output vector to the host CPU. Common CPU and GPU systems are processor-centric systems with high computation capabilities, while real PIM systems are memory-centric systems with high bandwidth capabilities. So when we're considering only the kernel time without accounting for the data transfer cost, we found that the SPMV kernel execution on a real PIM system achieves a much higher fraction of the peak performance compared to that of CPU and GPU systems, thereby providing a much higher total cost of ownership and higher resource utilization. Instead, when considering the end-to-end execution, including the data transfer costs for the input and output vectors, the CPU system performs best. However, PIM systems are still maturing, and future PIM systems are expected to reduce data transfer costs, for example, by integrating the PIM-enabled memory modules as the main memory, of the system. Please refer to our archive paper for many more key insights. In conclusion, sparse matrix vector is a fundamental linear algebra kernel. However, in commodity processor-centric systems like CPUs and GPUs, it is highly bottlenecked by data movement between processor and memory. Real near-bank PIM systems can tackle the data movement problem by placing low-area cores very close to DRAM banks, thereby being a very good fit to accelerate the SPMV kernel. To this end, we have designed the first open-source SPMV library for real PIM systems, which is called SparseP, and it is publicly available on the GitHub link at the end of this slide. And we also provide the first comprehensive characterization study of 25 efficient SPMV kernels on the first commercially available real PIM architecture. Our work provides new insights and recommendations for software designers and hardware architects in order to improve multiple aspects of future PIM software and hardware. For more details on our work, we invite you to read our full archive paper. Thank you so much for your attention.